A summer warm Sunday at the end of September, we are looking north from the Kronstad hill towards the lake Store Lungårdsvann with Bergen city center behind. Join me for a 3D sightseeing trip now and 100 years ago. Earlier, Store Lungårdsvann was hidden behind wooden fences and industry buildings. The building to the right was a workshop making car and bus bodies. Now it houses art studios and a gallery, but still also an auto repair shop. Lake Store Lungårdsvann is actually part of the sea. It is connected to the Solheimsviken Bay, where the shipyard Bergen Mekaniske Verksted was operating until 1991. Now the area is transforming just as fast as Store Lungårdsvann. The restaurant Kolonialen Kran, the crane, is one last reminder of the industry here. Behind Kolonialen Kran, offices and a hotel is under construction. More outdoor restaurants are surely opening here in the near future. In Solheimsviken Bay, new condos with direct access to the waterfront have replaced industry. Småpudden Bridge for walkers and bikers opened in 2016. It connects Solheimsviken with the rest of the city. Here the bridge is lifted to let a sailboat pass. People often gather to watch as they wait for the bridge to close again. At the other side of Småpudden Bridge is the Møhlenpris district with Marineholmen, where a new city beach was opened in 2018. Close by is Corner Theatre, a scene where independent groups can perform and guests can enjoy a drink at a restaurant this Indian summer day. On Sundays you can also check out a flea market close by. We walk northeast into the park Nygårdsparken, constructed in the 1880s, inspired by English landscape parks. For many years, this part of the park was a place for drug traffic, shunned by other citizens. But in 2017 it reopened with a café pavilion. As we see, it is also used for other new activities. Some distance to the northwest we find the main square, Torgallmenningen. In old times, this wide square was meant to stop city fires from spreading. After the city fire of 1916, the square was rebuilt in its present form, and in 1950 the central seafaring monument was unveiled. Torgallmenningen Square stretches down to Fiskebryggen, the fisherman's wharf, but what about this place in older times? 150 years ago, stereo photography was starting to get popular. Here we see the fishing boats and busy bargaining. Around the year 1900, Fiskebryggen Wharf was much narrower than today, but still they had room for tramway tracks. The Hanseatic storehouses in the narrow alleys were filled with all kinds of wares, not with tourists. Two rather well-off guys pose in front of the Holberg statue at Vågsalmenningen Square, not far from the Fiskebryggen Wharf. The distance between rich and poor was small in meters, but large in wealth. Over 100 years later, the fishermen and their boats are gone, and tourists are strolling between the selling stands, or they enjoy the view towards Fiskebryggen and the Vågen Bay. The old Hanseatic buildings are still there, but the pier in front of them is much wider than 100 years ago. Hanseatic trade has been replaced with cafes for the tourists and a roadway, but the tramway is gone. And the fishing boats are replaced by leisure boats. Moving to the south, we see that Bergen still has a tramway, or rather a city rail. Here it is departing for Bergen Airport Flesland. And we make a short break at Byparken City Park. And nearby Lille Lungårdsvann. Further south, we approach the area where we started, Lake Store Lungårdsvann. Along the eastern shore, a new city rail line is constructed, along with a park and lanes for walking and biking. The shadows are getting longer, and we arrive at Møllendal at the southeastern end of Store Lungårdsvann. This marina will be moved and the area opened for yet another city beach. In Møllendal, industrial buildings have given way for yet another Almenning, a public square in front of the Faculty for Art, Music and Design, designed by famous Norwegian architect bureau Snøhetta. Even now, late in September, it is possible to sunbathe or even go for a dip in the salty water. And here at Store Lungårdsvann, an area in rapid transition, we say farewell to the probably last summer warm day this autumn. Thank you for watching.